I think it's so important to support independent film, especially films that may not get the widest distribution. I think it's great the initiative that BIFA have come up with, that they're going to screen some of the nominated films in cinemas around the country. I think it's wonderful the public are going to be able to see those films.
What do you think is the magic of independent cinema? What does it offer audiences that mainstream blockbuster cinema perhaps doesn't?
They're more prepared to take a risk in terms of storytelling and do it in a way that is convincing and realistic, and or not, if they so choose. It's a risk they want to take of playing something completely absurd and obscure and a whole new take of and weird way of looking at things that perhaps a lot of people won't get or even like, but some people will absolutely love it and just make people think and question things, which I think films should do. And I would say in the bigger budget stuff wouldn't take those risks because it doesn't equal good return, really. And I think independent film is about film being an art form, and that's what it is, and that's what it should be. And I think a lot can be learned from independent film. I think independent film casts for who is perfect for that part and gets the crew that are perfect for that job to try and make the best possible product. And when you put all those things together, you create this kind of melting pot of creativity and allow everyone to come together to tell this one story. And the amount of work and effort that goes into that is something I've always found fascinating about film. And I think independent film does that in the most exciting way.
It's a phenomenal lineup this year, led by people like Kate Winslet. Gemma, I guess starting with you, is there anyone in particular, either individual films or performances, that you're especially pleased to see recognised here this year?
Yeah, well, I'm pleased to see The Lobster being nominated, and Amy, of course. Thought that was brilliant.
I really enjoyed Ex Machina, and also The Lobster. I enjoyed The Lobster too. I mean, it's people make films because they love to make films, but they don't make them for themselves. It's to share, and if people don't know about them, then they don't go and see them. So, I mean, to try and throw them out there as much as possible, so that the general public actually get the opportunity to go to the cinema and see a film as it's supposed to be seen is what it's all about, surely. Yeah.
Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. We're so excited about that. What does it mean for you to be a part of that world?
Oh, I'm such a huge fan of the books and the films. It's an exciting world to join, and everyone's been very welcoming so far.
See, Eddie is a fantastic leading man. Are you excited about the prospect of working with him?
Yeah, he's wonderful. It's very exciting.
You were at Comic-Con with the MCN Comic-Con with Thunderbirds the other weekend. Did you enjoy that experience and obviously being part of another huge legacy in Thunderbird?
Yeah, I was always a huge Thunderbirds fan growing up, and it's like a childhood dream, really, to be a Thunderbird. And, it was great to go to Comic-Con and meet the fans of the original series, and now, a few fans of our take on the original series, and that's great. And it's adding to a legacy, but giving it its respect where respect's due, and just bringing it up to date slightly.
It's been a lovely surprise for all of us. I think maybe it's something to do with the whole the ideas involved in artificial intelligence. There's something at the moment everyone's very excited about it. There's so much going on, and there's progress being made every day in the real world. So I think people really liked kind of seeing these kinds of stories being told in a way that they hadn't seen before, in a very kind of domestic setting. And our show was more about the emotional and philosophical impact of having this AI technology on our everyday lives. I don't know. I think the characters, people cared about them, and we're really happy that people have enjoyed the show.